back, but I didn't. I couldn't judge, you know, judge a deal.
Yeah,
you know, I mean that's where it's looking like. You know what I mean? So you obviously got to see after the fight and we'll go from there.
Any time frame on that, Ryan?
For me and Devin, that's gonna happen regardless. All these fights are gonna happen.
I'm talking about JoJo. I'm talking about this.
Oh, time frame: November, December.
November, yeah. December time frame.
Ryan, if Tank fights Rowley, who wins?
You know, surprisingly, I think that would be actually a somewhat competitive fight. You know, because I know Rowley's didn't look too good, but he always has that X factor. You know, there's something about his power and, you know, he has good timing sometimes. So, obviously, I think Tank's going to beat him, but I think he has a shot to knock him out.
And if Manny did retire, I know Manny loves you and he sends you messages and a DM. If he did retire, what's his legacy in your eyes?
The second thing closest to Muhammad Ali. That's what I think, honestly. And I don't think that's too far off. He's only 8-time division world champion. He's about to become the president of the Philippines.
Hopefully.
If you look back at his career, you could say he's the closest thing to Muhammad Ali.
People's champ, yeah.
Definitely, 100%.
Ryan, looking deeper into the Canelo Plant fight, Andre Ward's assisting Canelo Plant. How do you think that's going to benefit?
Andre Ward can't fight for Plant. So it doesn't matter. You could give all the advice that you want. It's not going to change anything.
It's the same thing because you're always in the gym with Canelo and he helps you too.
It's not gonna help. It does help me, I guess, but you're still your fighter. You're still gonna be you.
He kind of felt that you know, he knows Plant a bit, and he felt that he stood a good chance to win this fight, so he's kind of trying to help him out a bit. Do you see that at all, even with Ward's assistance?
No, I don't think he's going to do anything. I mean, Ward's helped a lot of the fighters, right? Mm-hmm. And then a lot of them get beat.
You posted a tweet the other day saying, hey, that's a serious accusation. Yeah. Devin Haney talking about your camp and just talking about your body in general.
Yeah.
Just sound off on that. How did that make you feel? Him basically saying that your whole gym is cheating. That's a pretty serious accusation, especially nowadays in boxing. What do you have to say to that?
Well, yeah, I wasn't even I never even responded to tweets for a long time, and then I seen that and I was like, man, that rubbed me the wrong way. You know, you can't do that. That's just disrespectful. One and two, it's
unethical.
Unethical and it's just bad all around. Yeah. So. Yeah, he's dumb for that. I felt like slapping him in the face.
What do you tell Devin and Plant accusing the whole gym? That includes your son, Ryan. They're accusing them of being cheaters.
Do I look? I wish I had some steroids. Damn. I'd be a little bigger or something. I would look a little better.
You have to have facts in order to say something out there, especially out to the media. You have to have facts. If you don't have facts, please don't say anything. You know, it's just speculation. Don't do that because you offend real boxers, you offend people that, you know, are just working hard, just like they are. So just keep it real.
If anything, he works with Victor Conte. I mean, we can speculate all